नमस्कार दोस्तों, INZ एजुकेयर चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट की पायलट प्रोजेक्ट सीरीज द इकॉन सीरीज में मैं चिरायु भट्ट आपका हार्दिक स्वागत करता हूं। आज हम बहुत ही खुशकिस्मत है कि हमारे साथ प्रोफेसर गामिनी जयसूर्या बैठे हैं। गामिनी जयसूर्या जी हैज टॉट इकोनॉमिक्स फॉर द लास्ट 50 years। ही हैज टॉट इकोनॉमिक्स इन इंग्लैंड, श्रीलंका, स्विट्जरलैंड, थाईलैंड एंड फॉर द लास्ट 30 years ही हैज बीन टीचिंग इकोनॉमिक्स इन न्यूजीलैंड। सर, how did you fell in love with economics? Can you please start?
When I was young, the main thing was to get into the university in Sri Lanka first to start with. And at that time, the Sri Lankan economy was not doing well. So I just got interested in that. And more than anything else, our first year economics lecturer was so good. I got interested in the subject. And then I thought, I will specialize in this. That is how I specialized in economics.
Right. Let me tell you, Gamini sir taught me economics as well when I was studying PGDIB and MBA in AIS St. Helens. He taught me EDM and world economy. Sir, the economy of New Zealand has contracted by 1% in the December quarter. What's your take on it?
Because we are not investing. That's one big problem we have. And we depend so much on trade. New Zealand economy is a very small economy. And we are located in the furthest corner of this world. We depend on trade. We can't survive on our own. And some of the things we trade are the agricultural products. And the other one is what we are doing, education and tourism. If those things go down, our economy cannot survive. The education industry is a 5 billion industry. Tourism is a 16 billion industry. And the rest is all agriculture. If we don't trade, if we don't have exports and imports, we just can't survive. So that is New Zealand's problem. And we have just shut down the economy.
Yes.
You can't shut the economy down. You can take precautions, but you have to still operate the economy.
You are recommending that we need to open the borders ASAP.
We have to open up the economy,
yes,
but with certain precautions. Take all the precautions, do the testing, do anything you like. But we have to open the economy to the rest of the world. We can't survive on our own. Country like America, they can survive on their own. They're a big economy.
Yes.
We are a small economy. We are dependent on overseas trade.
Mm-hmm.
We have to get students. The universities are losing big money without the students. Tourist trade is down. Hotels are losing money. All tourist companies are in trouble. You know that. I don't have to tell you. There are hundreds of thousands of dollars are lost every day. We have to open up the economy. Look after the health. That is important. We get the vaccination. Even the vaccination is very slow.
Yes.
We should have got it by now, but no, we're not getting it.
Yes.
So that is the problem with our government, I think. So they have to speed up things. We can't keep the economy shut down.
Yes. So what is the future ahead for us? Where do you see New Zealand economy after 6 months or 1 year?
If we can open up the economy as early as possible and get the vaccinations also at the same time, we can pick up. We
right.
can pick up and we can get out of the recession. Recessions are very harmful, as you know. You know, it causes unemployment, GDP comes down, companies are closed down. So we have to get out of the recession. The only way to get out of the recession is we have to open up to the rest of the world. Because we are dependent on the rest of the world. We can't survive on our own. It's a very small economy. And all our prosperity is dependent on trade. Export of agricultural products. I mean, we produce first-class cheese in this country. We, I think, produce the best butter in the world. The best quality butter is produced here, not anywhere else. And our education system is good. Get the students to come here.
Yes.
And our tourism. This is a beautiful country. There are so many places to go. Tourists like to come here. Get them to come here. We can't shut the economy down. So the only way is we have to take the necessary precautions, but still open up the economy. It's not about shutting down the economy.
Great. So the message is very loud and clear from Gamini sir. We need to open the border ASAP so that the economy starts functioning again.
You know the good old saying?
Yes.
Don't kill the patient to cure him.
Yes.
You don't kill the patient to cure him. You understand? Yes, the problem is solved when the patient dies. Cure
yes.
the patient.
Very good saying.
That's
yes.
what we have to do.
Yes.
That's what we learn in school.
Yes. Right. Sir, NZ house prices are skyrocketing. Where are we failing and what can the government do to cool things down? I know this is your favorite subject as well.
Yeah. The biggest failure is housing has become the best and the most profitable investment. In my job, I had to work every day to earn my money. and then they tax me at 33%. You understand?
Yes.
And I am contributing to the GDP of this country. I'm educating people. But this gentleman buys your house, just sit on it for 1 year, do nothing, and then sell it to him for 100,000 more. He doesn't pay tax on the 100,000.
Yes.
I earn 100,000, I pay 33,000 as tax. He buys and sells a house, he makes 100,000, he pays more tax. So the capital gains tax is a must to stop this housing boom. Otherwise, this will go on. But no government or the prime minister has the guts to do that.
Yes.
I don't know the reason. I don't think anybody is going to lose the election just because you bring the capital gains tax. Everybody who earns money is taxed.
Yes.
Why not the person who sells a house?
Great.
And he's doing nothing. He's not raising one finger for the economy.
Hmm.
I work every day to earn this money and I get taxed. You don't work at all. You buy his house. Just sit on it, watch television, go to parties. At the end of the year, you sell the house to him.
Yes.
You make 100,000, no tax. That is the problem. You have to bring that tax in. So long as that is not done, you know what happens? The most profitable investment in life is buy and sell houses. People have 10, 12 houses in this country. They're just buying and selling. So that is all easy money. That is the problem. And they don't pay tax.
अगर सरकार वाकई में इस प्रश्न को सॉल्व करना चाहती है तो गामिनी सर ये कह रहे हैं कि वी हैव टू ब्रिंग कैपिटल गेन्स टैक्स इन दिस कंट्री एज सून एज पॉसिबल इफ दे आर सीरियस इन टैकलिंग दिस प्रॉब्लम दिस इज द रेमेडी जी सर
वी हैव टू ब्रिंग दैट टैक्स इमीडिएटली अदरवाइज द टैक्सेशन सिस्टम इज अनफेयर द टैक्सेशन सिस्टम मस्ट बी फेयर टू एवरीबॉडी बट पीपल हु बाय हाउसेस एंड सेल हाउसेस व्हिच इज ऑल दे डू देयर इज नो टैक्स दैट इज नॉट फेयर दे आर आल्सो मेकिंग मनी Then don't tax the other people. So what has happened is, people now don't want to do any business.
Yes.
If you set up a business, you have to work hard. And there is no guarantee that you will make profit. The business can lose. Buying house, there is never a loss.
Yes.
Because house prices keep going up because of the shortage.
Mm-hmm.
So you are investing in a business where you cannot lose. And then you make a profit and that is not taxed. Other people who are doing all kinds of businesses, producing tables, chairs, clothes, doesn't matter. They are running a risk.
Yes.
Because the business can fail.
Yes.
Sales can go down, but they have to pay tax.
Yes.
So the whole taxation system is very unfair.
Yes.
It's not a fair system of taxation.
Do we have a model to imitate, sir, in the world? Is there any country who has successfully tackled this problem?
I can't think of one place, but Singapore is one.
Singapore
is one.
What did they do?
That's why they have the capital gains tax. That is why they are a successful economy.
Yes.
They encourage people to do engaging productive activities. Buying houses and selling houses is not a productive
activity. Yes.
You're not raising one finger for the economy. I buy your house, sell it to him, he sells it to him. At each point, everybody is making money.
Yes.
But they do nothing for the country.
Yes.
They do nothing for the country, they do nothing for the economy. That is what is wrong.
Best answer. Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah, you're welcome.
This is the highlighted question of the interview. If you were the finance minister, Grant Robertson, what are the three things that you would do to fasten the economic activity in New Zealand?
First thing, I will start impose a capital gains tax. And I'll have a fairly high capital gains tax, one. Second one, bring tax rates down to business people and so on, because they are in productive activities. They not only produce goods and services, and we export. Remember, we are dependent on exports most of the time.
Yes.
So that brings money into the country.
Yes.
And also they create jobs. Housing market creates no jobs. So give some encouragement to them. Bring the taxes down.
Yes.
Don't tax people too high, people who are in productive activities. That's the second most important thing.
Yes.
The other one is try and find a solution to this one. Get the vaccinations quickly and open up the economy. We can't have this closed economy. A big country, maybe it's possible. Australia is a big country. America is a big country. Russia is a big country. They may be able to operate inside. We have to be open to the rest of the world.
Mm-hmm.
Because we are a small economy. We depend on other people.
Yes.
Tourism, we have to get tourists to come here. Because remember, this is a beautiful country.
And they will spend money and people still, will get the...
People spend money. And tourists are people who spend money. Let's get their money. Education, I told you, is a 5 billion industry. Tourism is a 16 billion industry. They are not doing either of them. That is a failure by the government. That is a problem. That is the way to solve the problem. There is no other solution.
Yes.
Hmm.
Do you think the economic might of China has decreased and will continue to decrease in the backdrop of COVID-19?
It has come slowed down a bit like all other economies in the world, because with this trade has slowed down, everything has slowed down, but China is still a very strong economy. They are the second biggest economy in the world. The USA is number one, China is number two, and China has come to number two from nowhere.
Yes.
Under Mao Zedong, it was far down. It was about 100 and something.
Sir, I remember you shared a beautiful story with us when we were studying, that there was a Chinese economist who used to teach in America, and he went to China and he saw poverty and hunger everywhere. Yeah. And then he recommended to the government that you need to open the economy. Can you please share that story with us?
I can't remember that person's name now.
Yes.
But he was in America and he came and told Deng Xiaoping.
Yes.
Under Mao, it was all closed economy.
Yes.
They told Deng Xiaoping, open up the economy. That's the only way we can progress.
Yes.
Let people do what they want. Mm-hmm. Don't tell them what to do. Let people decide what they want to do.
Yes.
Then they'll decide what to do. Don't tell people what to do. People are intelligent people. They know what to do. Just leave them alone.
Yes.
Let them do what they like. Give them the freedom. And that is what Deng Xiaoping did. Because when Deng Xiaoping couldn't understand why China was poor, Chinese people are intelligent people. They study. But then they were so backward. And then he found out after going to America and so on. Leave the economy alone. Let people do what they like. And that is how China became the second biggest economy in the world. It's all due to Deng Xiaoping.
Wow.
He's the man who did that.
Brilliant story. The message is again loud and clear from the genius lecturer, that you need to leave people alone. They need to decide what they want to do. Government has no business to be in business. Thank you, sir. The next question is, you taught us the Keynesian model, that whenever there is recession, government needs to spend more on infrastructure and there needs to be some direct benefit transfer. Yeah. That's what the New Zealand government did in COVID-19, that they introduced the wage subsidy. But some critics, they are saying that rather than giving the subsidy to employers, the subsidy should have been given to the employees so that the leakages and the fraud could have been stopped.
But it's the employers who create jobs. They are the people who run businesses. It's important to prop them up. If they collapse, all the jobs are lost.
Yes.
So rather than giving to the employee, it's always good to give to the employer so that he keeps his business running. You know, most businesses are in serious trouble right now.
Mm-hmm.
There are lots of them are on the verge of collapse now. So give them the subsidy so that they continue to produce. If they produce, the workers have a job. If the university shuts down, I don't have a job. So we have to prop up the university and make it going so that they can employ all the people. So that's the correct way to do it. Make sure your businesses don't collapse. They are the creators of jobs. They are the ones who create jobs. They are the ones who give jobs. So if they collapse, then the jobs are gone. If you give it to the workers, they'll spend the money. That's all.
Yes.
That's why.
Thank you.
I'm also a worker, you see.
Yes. Last question, sir. The OCR and interest rates are historically low at the moment in New Zealand. What do you think will happen to OCR in the next 6 months?
I don't think they are going to bring it down, because you can't bring it down any further. It's very, very low, but you can't raise it so long as the economy is slow. But once the economy picks up in the next 6 months to 8 months, they will raise the OCR. The OCR has to be raised always when the economy picks up. Otherwise, there will be inflation. So inflation is something that's very harmful, as you know.
Too much money chasing too few goods.
Yeah. You know that one. And inflation, we say, is a cancer on the economic body. You know what happens if I get cancer, I die.
Yes.
So inflation is a cancer on the economic body. Right. And that is why we have to keep inflation down. So the Reserve Bank governor has to be very watchful. Right now, yes, it is low. But what's happening is, with interest rates low, people are investing in houses. So what's the big idea? That doesn't help.
Right. Sir, India was on the verge of bankruptcy in 1990-1991 when the then Finance Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh opened up the economy. Mm-hmm. And people say that he has played a very pivotal role in bringing up the GDP of India. Mm-hmm. But some of the people, they criticize him a lot. They say that he hasn't done enough for the economy. What are your thoughts about Dr. Manmohan Singh?
I thought he was very good. That's just my view. I thought he did a very good job. Before that was Mrs. Indira Gandhi.
Before him, there were several prime ministers. Yes.
He did a good job compared to Indira Gandhi. I don't know what you feel about it. You are Indian, so you know. You know, Indira Gandhi was like our prime minister here. You see, interfering in everything.
Yes.
just leave the economy alone. That's the main thing.
Yes.
Don't interfere with the economy. People know what to do. People are educated people. They are knowledgeable.
Yes.
These business people, they may not have gone to university, but they know business.
Yes.
They know how to invest. You don't have to come to university to understand business. So that is why that's what happened to India. So Manmohan Singh was quite good there.
Yes.
I know some people didn't like him, but I liked him. As an economist, I liked him.
Great. Thank you. Any other thoughts about New Zealand economy and world economy, sir, before we wrap up this interview?
No, even the world economy has slowed down.
Yes.
So if the world economy doesn't pick up, it's very difficult for us to pick up because we are so dependent on the rest of the world. A country like India, America, they can survive on their own. They're big economies. We have a very small economy. We depend so much on what happened to the rest of the world. So if America recovers, American recovery is very important because it's the biggest economy. And if Australia recovers, then we can also recover. But the rest of the world is very important to us because we produce very few goods and services. We depend on the world. All these imports that come in to us, coming from other countries. And if we export, we make money. To buy the imports, we have to export. We don't have the money otherwise.
Yes.
So we have to export. So we have to get out of this, you see. That is why we have to have the vaccination. Take all the precautions, but open up. Open up for tourism. Take the precautions at the border. Take precautions. Medical people should know that. And let them come. Because they spend money. They are the people who have money.
Yes.
That's the problem. So opening up the economy is a critical thing. That's what I tell in the class every day. Open up the economy. We can't close it like this.
थैंक यू सो मच सर, इट वॉज वेरी इन्फॉर्मेटिव.
थैंक यू वेरी मच.
देवी और सज्जनों, जैसा कि आपने देखा, गामिनी सर ने अलग अलग टॉपिक पे हमसे बात की और द मैसेज वॉज वेरी लाउड एंड क्लियर फ्रॉम हिम. अगर आप हाउसिंग की प्राइसेस डाउन करना चाहते हैं तो कैपिटल गेन टैक्स लगाना पड़ेगा और इकोनॉमी को एज सून एज पॉसिबल ओपन करना पड़ेगा. अगले एपिसोड में ऐसी किसी शख्सियत से मुलाकात करेंगे. तब तक के लिए धन्यवाद. थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू.